So yesterday we learned about the operators. If anyone having doubt regarding the operator, do let me know. Sanveer, please mute yourself. Anyone else, if you have any doubt regarding the operator, please do let me know for proceed further. What? Yes. That we will do the later on. That we will do the later on. How to calculate the, that is simple formula. That add all number and divide it by the number of items. That is simple way to do the calculate the, you know, this average. Yes, we have formula. We have formula. We have formula. We will discuss it later on. I will give you the assignment for the same, that you have to calculate the percentage marks of students. So you have to do some kind of research first. Then I will tell you how we can find it out. Okay. So the next topic is, let me present my. Okay, my screen is visible to everyone? Visible to everyone? Just please do let me know. Okay, so it's mean everyone. So, the yesterday topic was operators. We understand in great detail what exactly the operators and what are the types of operator available inside the Python. So, today I will touch the further, you know, the data types that we discussed day before yesterday. The data types that we have, we discuss int, we discuss about float, we discuss about str. Okay, now I am proceeding further. I will touch today the complex, okay, and I will touch the list, I will touch this dictionary, and I will touch this set, and I will touch this tuple. Today we will cover all these, and after completion of all these basic introduction, I will give you this basic introduction about the dictionary, set, tuple and all these things, and later I will give you one assignment and I will tell you how we can proceed with the input method. Okay, so that is the later on part for today's session. So now I am touching these data types, the remaining data types, that byte, array, frozen set, we will discuss this later on. So today is our major focus on all these data types, and we will cover all these in great detail. Okay, so now the next concept is the type casting. Okay, the type casting. What exactly meaning of the type casting? To convert one data type to another. That concept is called type casting. Let me check. Sanveer, please mute yourself here. Perfect. Now, the convert one data type to another. This concept is called typecasting. Now, what exactly meaning of this? Just do, you know, just let's take a simple example. I am saying 10, okay, and I am saying this 20. Okay, these two, what are these two? These two are the in the form of the integer. These two are in the form of the integer. Okay, so I want to add these two numbers. For adding two numbers, that I know, I have this plus operator. Okay, when I perform this plus operator on strings, then what will happen? Now understand this concept. I did it, x plus y. The type of x is string, the type of x, y is string. Now I am performing this plus operator on both of these strings, then what you will get? You will get 10 plus 20, and what output you will get? You will get 1020. Why so? Okay, the question is, why so we are getting this 1020? For this, this plus operator, this keep this point into the mind. This plus operator, when we perform this plus operator into the strings object, because this is the string, this is the string. Why so? We already discussed, into the double quote, whatever we write, that would be considered as a string, even into the single quote, even into the double quote, that would be considered as a string. Proof for the same, that we already know, the function name is type of x, then the output would be class of str. Now the question is, when I perform this plus operator on string objects, what output I will get? Okay, for this time I will get the output, that is the 1020. Why so? Because this concept is called concatenation. The meaning of the concatenation, to concat two string objects. Or if I elaborate this thing in, you know, in more detail, then this concept is called polymorphism. If you are from the engineering background, if you have heard about C++, you heard about classes, then you might have heard about this term, that concept is called polymorphism. I am just giving you the simple definition of polymorphism: ability to take then one or more form. Now understand this into the great detail. So when I perform this plus operator on two strings, it perform the concept of the concatenation. Okay, or same this plus operator, when I perform on the integers, then it perform the concept of the mathematical addition. This concept is called polymorphism, the ability to take then one or the more form. This operator is same, now understand this operator is same, but the operand is different to this time. Okay, operands are different to this time. When this plus operator perform on the integer, you are getting mathematical addition. When same operator perform on the strings, you are performing the concatenation. Technically, this particular scenario is called polymorphism. Okay, this concept is called polymorphism, ability to take then one or the more form. Okay, don't bother about this polymorphism. Okay, just keep this point into the mind, this concept technically called, because sometime if you sit inside the interview room, they might can ask what is the meaning of the polymorphism. So this is the best example to elaborate the concept of the polymorphism, ability to take then one or more form. This is the definition for the polymorphism, and this is the practical implementation of the polymorphism. Sir, when we use this plus operator, with the string operands, then it performs the concept of the concatenation. When same operator performed with integer object, it performs the concept of the mathematical addition. This is the concept of the polymorphism. Now back to this main point, the typecasting. Typecasting means to convert one data type to another data type. Now understand it. I am getting data into this format. Okay, I am getting data into this format. Now when I perform this plus operator on these two objects, I will get 1020. Perfect. But my requirement is I want 30. Now how I can get this 30? If both will be integer objects, then it will produce the 30 output. Now how I can achieve this 30? Now that concept is called typecasting. I am converting this string object to int object. Okay, I am converting this string object to int object. This typecasting, converting one data type to another data type, is called typecasting. Then how I can perform the typecasting? Now understand it. If I perform int 10, okay, int 10 plus int 20. Now what will happen? Now this 10 is converted into the integer. Now this become this 10. Okay, now this 20 become this 20, and this is the plus operator. Now you know very well, when this plus operator implemented on the integer objects, you will get the output, that would be 30. This concept is called typecasting. Repeating once again, converting one data type to another type is called typecasting. Okay, now keep one point into the mind. Keep. Now I'm writing, this is the important one. Okay, let's suppose this x is something like this, 10 at the rate. Okay, y is something like this, 20 at the rate. Okay, these both are this thing, but this is the special character. Okay, this is the special character. By mistake, if you do so, int of x plus int of y. Now, what will happen? Now you will get the error message. Why so? Because the special characters, these special character cannot be converted into the integer. okay, so when you are converting this data to integer, any string to integer basically, then make sure that string doesn't contain any special character. Even spaces are not allowed. Even spaces are not allowed. Let's suppose you are getting the data into this format 10 space. Space is again special character, and you are trying to convert it into the X. What will happen? You will get the error message. So keep this point into the mind. While converting the string into the integer, make sure that string contains only integer numbers. That's why you are supposed to convert it, otherwise you will get the error message. Now the question is, sir, I want to convert this one into the integer. Yes, we can. But for the same, we have to think about simple logic. Now in upcoming days, I will give you the assignment how we can remove the special characters from the given string. So this would be our assignment for the upcoming days. Okay, for this point of time, keep this point into the mind. If you are converting any string to integer, okay, this concept is called typecasting. If you are converting any string to integer, make sure that string doesn't contain any special. By mistake, if you try to do so, you will get the error. So keep this point into the mind. And this concept is called typecasting, converting one data type to another data type. This concept is called typecasting. Okay, now let's suppose I want to convert this integer value. Let's suppose this is the integer 1 and I want to convert it into the bool value. Now what exactly meaning of the bool? Bool will give you true or false. Okay, the bool is always boolean value. Boolean, true or false. You will get only two output, true or false. Okay, now I want to convert into the bool of x. What output I will get? I will get true. Okay, when I convert bool of 0, then it will consider as a false value. That already we discussed yesterday session. 1 mean true and 0 means false. Okay, these are the bits. Now let's suppose you want to convert this bool string x. Okay, now what output you will get? You will get the output that is the true. You will get the true output. Why so? Because string always convert. When you trying to convert any string into the bool, it will always give you the true output. So this concept is called typecasting, because this is the string data and I am explicitly converting it into the bool data. That is called typecasting. For example, 10.5, okay, 10.4, and you want to convert it into the integer of 10.4. What output you will get? You will get 10. Okay, so this concept is called typecasting. Clear? Does anyone having doubt to this concept? Please do let me know before proceeding further. Okay, so the next concept is complex data type. Okay, the complex data type. If you want to play with mathematics, the real part and imaginary part. Okay, imaginary part. Then how we can define this complex data type inside Python? For the same, what you have to do? X is equal to 10 plus 11j. Okay, 10 plus 11j. Now, this basically the complex data type is to define the two parts, one in the real part and the second one is the imaginary part. We might have studied this concept into the 10th standard or into the 9th standard. Okay, so this would be considered as a real part, real number. Okay, and this would be considered as a imaginary number. Now if I write this, what will happen? Now the type of this X, when I print type of this X, you will get the output that is the class of complex. Okay, that is the class of complex, because your interpreter automatically understand this would be considered as a complex data type. This is the representation of the complex data type inside the Python. I am repeating once again, x is equal to 10 plus 11j. Okay, so the second number 20 plus y is equal to 20 plus 12j. Okay, so this is complex number, this is complex number. When I perform this x plus y, what output I will get? I will get 30 plus 23 j. Okay, so this is the mathematical plus operator on these complex numbers. Okay, I want to check it out now. I want to check it out. 10 plus, let's suppose this is my number, 10 plus 11j. I want to see out what is the real part of x and what is the imaginary part of this x. So for the same, what you have to do, print of x dot real. What output you will get? You will get this 10. Okay, if I want to check out the imaginary part, how I can check it out? Print of x dot imag. okay, now what output you will get? 11j. Clear? So one point keep into the mind, this can be anything. What is the meaning of anything? This can be binary, okay, this can be octal, this can be octal, okay, this can be hexadecimal. Yes, acceptable, but this real part should always into the decimal numbers. Okay, so here you are supposed only to take decimal values, but here you can take binary data, you can take octal data, you can take hexadecimal data. So this is the complex data type. So let me show you some practical, so you guys will better understand. I am opening this python shell, and I already described into my that video, which I share you the link, how you can install and how you can, you know, open this shell. So first example was this one, x is equal to 10, y is equal to 20. Now I am performing x plus y. What output I am getting? 1020. Why so? Because this is the concept of the concatenation. Now, okay, one more time. Now this time my requirement is 30. I want to add these two numbers. Okay, for adding two numbers, c is equal to int of x plus int of y. Now what output c contains? C contains 30. Clear? Okay, let's suppose this. Now the second case, this one is this. Now this string contains 10 and this special character. Now if I try to convert it into the integer, immediately you will get the error message. Why so? Because this contains the special character, and special character cannot be converted into the integer. That's why you are getting the error message. One more case, y is equal to, okay, now this time 10 space. Now I want to convert it into the integer. Okay, I want to convert it into the integer. Now it is acceptable for this time. Why so? Because this interpreter, this shell, basically this shell automatically removes this is the concept of trimming the spaces. But when we do the programming into the notepad, at that time you will get the error message. So keep this point into the mind. Why here it is accepted? Because we are doing it into the shell. Okay, so shell automatically implicitly convert this space it automatically trim basically these spaces. But in the case of notepad, when we do the, you know, the base, when we try to make the lengthy codes, we will take the help of the notepad. But at that time, make sure it will not work. I will show you later on. Okay, for this point of time it is working. The same thing over here. Let's suppose x is equal to 10 comma 20 comma 30. Here it will acceptable. Okay, but this is a different concept. Okay, let me write again. Here this is the string. Okay, now if I want to convert it into the x, here it is not acceptable again. Because why so? Because it's contain the special character, and special characters cannot be converted into the integer. So keep this point into the mind. Here why so? I am repeating once again, if you have any doubt. Here why so it is accepted? Because we are working into the shell. Okay, and this shell, this Python, this is called shell, and this Python shell automatically convert these spaces, basically automatically remove these spaces. But inside notepad, when we write the actual codes, that time we have to take care about all these things. okay? So keep this point into the mind. So make your for the better practice, just if you want to convert any string into the integer, you have to remove all these things. Okay, so one take one more example. Let's suppose z is equal to I am writing 10 dollar sign and 20. Now at this time, if I convert it into the integer, again I will get the error message. Why? So again the special characters cannot be converted. Special characters cannot be converted into the integer. So the next data type was complex. Okay, so let me show you the complex first, then I will take your question. Okay, this is the complex. Let's suppose c is equal to 10 plus 11j. Okay, so how I can check it out, the type of this x is comp, sorry, type of this c, because I use the data that I use the variable name, that is the c. Okay, type of c, you will get the complex. Okay, so I want to check it out the real part, c dot real. I will get 10.0 because this is the real part. C dot image. Okay, now I will get the 11.0. so this is the imaginary part and this would be the real part. Okay, take one more. V is equal to 20 plus 30j. okay, now I am performing the mathematical operation, c plus v. Now c plus v, now you will get 30 plus 41j. This is the mathematical addition of v, this is the mathematical addition of this c. This is the concept of the complex data types. If you have any doubt, please do let me know before proceed further. Please hurry up. Anyone having any doubt, please do let me know. No? Ajay sir? Okay, perfect. Mohammed sir? Okay, no problem. I think Mohammed sir? Okay, perfect. Okay. Now proceed further. Now the next data types are list, already little bit discuss. Okay, set. So before writing the set, I am writing the tuple. Okay, this one is the tuple. The next is your dictionary. Okay, now the next is your set. So these are the basic data types. I will just describe the basic today. Okay, later on when we will proceed further, you are supposed to solve 5 to 10 problem statement with the help of this list. Okay, 5 to 7 problem with the help of this tuple. Okay, 5 to again 6 problem with the help of this dictionary, 5 to 7 problem with the help of this set. Okay, I will give you the assignment for the same. For this point of time, I am just giving you the introduction about all these things so that you guys will little familiar with all these things. Okay, so later on we will describe this thing into the great detail, in depth, what are the various method associated with this tuple, various method associated with the dictionary, various method associated with this set and list as well. Okay, for the same when we will describe the string into the great detail, I will give you 5 to 7 assignment for the same, and I will describe all the associated method that are used with the string class. I will discuss at that point of time. This is just introduction about this thing that we cover till now. Okay, so today's again do the same introduction about this list and tuple and dictionary and set, so that you guys will familiar with these concepts. And when I teach you the tough concepts, you don't feel it, okay sir, what is list, what is tuple, what is dictionary. That's why I'm giving the introduction about all these things. Now understand, as I already told you, Python is a dynamically typed programming language. So dynamically typed, repeat, just take a 1 second to you guys to get familiar with you guys. The dynamically type is basically no need to define the data types of variable prior to use them. So in case of list, in case of tuple, in case of dictionary, in case of set, how we can represent it on the Python shell. So for the same, if I write this, L is equal to this one, okay, L is equal to this one, this would be considered as a list. If I write this, T is equal to this one, this would be considered as a tuple. If I write this, D is equal to this one, this would be considered as a dictionary. If I write this, S is equal to this one, this would be considered as a set. Now you guys will ask me a question, sir, the representation of dictionary and the representation of set, both are same. Yes, both are same, but keep this point into the mind. The priority of the dictionary is higher than the set. So if I write something like this, my Python interpreter will take both as a dictionary, but the representation of dictionary and set are same. But yes, there is difference. When we will come this point, I will let you know what exactly the difference between set and what exactly difference between dictionary and what exactly difference between set. But this point of time, if you write something like this and you press the type of D, you press the type of S, in the both of cases you will get the output at the class of dict and class of dict, both of the cases, because repeating once again, the priority of the dictionary is higher than the set. That's why my interpreter, if you define something like this, my interpreter will consider both of the cases as a dictionary. Okay, now I am leaving this point over here, I am coming back to this. Now let's suppose this is the list. What is the list? List is the collection of heterogeneous objects. Now what is the meaning of the heterogeneous objects? The collection of different data types. For example, L is equal to 101. Okay, I am writing here RAM. Okay, I am writing here 80.5. I am writing here Chandigarh, whatever. Okay, so by default the indexing is 0. Indexing is 0. Always indexing starting from 0, that positive indexing already discussed. Here same negative indexing always start from -1. Yes, negative indexing is also applicable with list object, also applicable with your string object, also applicable with tuple objects. Okay, so if I do this print of L of 0, what output I will get? I will get 101. Perfect. I think no question till now. Okay, again print of L of 1, I will get output, that is the RAM. Again, I suppose there is no question till now. This is the concept of the list, and I am showing you a very very basic function, basically basic method that is associated with this list, and that method name is called append. Okay, append. What is the meaning of the append? Now in computer science, if I used word append in programming languages or into the file handling or anywhere inside computer, if I talk about computer and I use this append, so keep this point into the mind. Append always means that end of file or end of data. That's it. Keep this point into the mind. Inside computer science, if I use this append word, the meaning of the append is at the end of the data or at the end of the file. Okay, so if I use this append with L is my list, and I want to append over here, let's suppose the pin number. For the same, what I have to do? L of append. What I want to append? I want to append, let's suppose the pin number. Now this append is a method, it's a method which is associated with this list, and the role of this append is to add the content into the list. Now if I print L, what will happen? Now what output I will get? I will get 101 RAM, 80.5 CHD and 16 0042. Why so? Because we already discussed this is the fall under the category of the mutable, so we can add the content, we can change this RAM to Ram Kumar. Why so? Because this list is fall under the under the mutable objects, and mutable objects are the changeable objects. In my last session that I discuss about in great detail the mutable objects. Okay, so this is one of the function, and later on when we will proceed further, there are approximately 10 to 15 such kind of methods which are associated with the list, and we will describe them one by one in great detail. For this point of time, I just give you the introduction about what exactly the methods are there, and later on we will discuss into the great detail. So this is very basic introduction about the list. I think you guys clear about the list. List is the mutable objects where you can add the heterogeneous object, where you can change the content, where you can append the content. Why so? Because this is the mutable. Now the next is tuple. Tuple, this is the representation of the tuple inside the Python. You can say tuple or you can say tuple. Pronunciation is depend upon you. Okay, so how we can represent the tuple? Again, the collection of the heterogeneous objects, 101 101, RAM 80.5, okay, CHD. Okay, so this is the tuple objects. Why, how I can identify these are the tuple objects? Because of these braces. Here the braces are square braces, here the braces are round braces. Okay, this is the only difference between tuple and list, representation difference. Okay, now here this is the immutable objects. We know it very well. This is the immutable objects. Very good. Immutable mean which cannot be changeable. So same, what if I do it? Okay, print of t of 0 perfectly, you will get the output that is the 101 perfectly. Slicing is applicable, slicing and indexing is applicable. Okay, if I print t of minus 1, what output I will get? I will get this CHD object. Why so? Again, it deal with the negative indexing. Yes, you can do the negative indexing over here perfectly, you can do it. Okay, but now carefully understand it. Now I want to add here the pin number. Okay, I do the same thing. T dot append of this 160042. Now immediately you will get the error. The append is not associated with this tuple. Why so? Because this fall under the immutable objects, and immutable objects, you cannot change the content of the immutable objects. Rest the things are same inside the tuple and inside the list. You can do slicing, yes. You can do indexing, yes. Okay, you can do negative indexing, you can do the positive indexing. Everything is same into the list, into the tuple, but only difference is one is fall under the mutable and the second one is fall under the immutable. Now I think clear this concept. And there are some methods, there are not many methods, there are approximately 5 to 4 methods which are associated with this tuple. We will define the later on when we will proceed further. Okay, now the next concept is set and dictionary. Okay, if you guys have any doubt till now, do let me know for this list and for this tuple. Please do let me know, then I will proceed with dictionary and with set. Please hurry up. Sir, okay. Sir, append is a predefined method. The Python automatically give you some methods. Let me show you how many methods are associated with this list. Okay. Just let me. Sir, one second. I will give you the justification. Okay. Sir, this is the list, and if I press L dot tab. Okay, so these are the methods which are associated with this list. Okay, the first method is append. What exactly role of append? Okay, sir, now understand carefully. Sir, I want to add something. Okay, today's you are married. Okay, you mention. Okay, just take a simple scenario. Today I have two person. Okay, one person is married and the second person is unmarried. Okay, for the married person, the question genuine is that what's your wife name, how many children you have. Okay, what is the qualification of your children? For unmarried person, these questions are invalid. But I am using this list. Let's suppose I am maintaining your data. Your roll number is 101, your employee ID is 101, and your name is this one. Okay, लेट्स सपोज व्हाटएवर, ठीक है, ओके, जस्ट टेक अ नेम एग्जांपल, राम. टुडे राम इज अनमैरिड, टुडे राम इज अनमैरिड, बट टुमारो राम इज मैरिड. सो आई हैव टू अपडेट दिस कंटेंट, अपडेट दिस कंटेंट, ओके, आई वांट टू अपडेट दिस कंटेंट. फॉर अपडेटिंग दिस कंटेंट आई हैव टू एड सम टाइप ऑफ डेटा एट द एंड ऑफ दिस, एट द एंड ऑफ दिस, ओके, एट द एंड ऑफ दिस. फॉर द सेम वट आई हैव टू डू, फॉर द सेम वट आई हैव टू डू, आई हैव टू एड द कंटेंट. फॉर एडिंग द कंटेंट इन साइड द लिस्ट वी हैव ऑलरेडी ए मैथड, दैट मैथड इज कॉल्ड अपेंड. ओके, दिस इज द वन एग्जाम्पल. द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल, लेट सपोज यू डू द शॉपिंग विद मी, ओके, यू डू द शॉपिंग विद मी, ओके, यू बाय अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ $10, देन सेकेंड प्रोडक्ट $20. After immediately, when you are going for the billing counter, immediately you want to buy something else. Okay, no problem at all. No problem at all. Now you come back to this point, and I am appending, appending one more, appending one more, appending one more. Now the content has been appended. Now finally you take the bill. Now finally you take the bill. Now inside bill, inside bill. Okay, at that time the concept is called tuple. I am giving you the usage of the list, and I am giving you the usage of the tuple. Because when your bill is done, when your bill is done, after that I am not supposed to change this bill. Okay, your bill has been printed out. You do the payment, and inside my record, that person buys this much of product, and this product I cannot be changeable by mistake. Let's suppose you buy the product of the $10, and it has been changed to the $20, and next day you are claiming it. I bought the product of $20, but I received the product of $10. Then how I can manage this scenario? Okay. Then how I can manage this scenario? So this is the concept. Yes, yes. Append inside computer science. Keep this point into the mind, because now you are this student of the computer science or programming languages. Inside computer, whether I am talking about anything inside the computer, and I use this append word blindly, say append mean to add the content end of the data, or if in the context of the file, add the content to the end of the file. This is the concept of the append, because later on we will use the append mode to add the content into the files. That's why I am clearing the picture for this point of time. Haji, any now I think I Yeah, middle of it, that definitely we can do it. Yes. No. For that there is different method. That method is called insert. That method is called insert. We will describe these on later on. Okay. Anyone having any doubt till now between list and this tuple, please do let me know. Ajay sir. Okay, great. Mohammed sir, do you have any doubt? Okay, perfect, nice. So proceed further. Now I am touching this point. I am touching this dictionary and set. Okay, now I am removing it. Now the next is dict. Okay, now the next is dict and this set. Very basics. Sanvi sir, do you have any doubt? I forgot you are also inside the class. One new person is with us. The name of the person is Sanveer, and he is my colleague. We are working together in same institute. Hello, Sanveer. Do you have any doubt? Doubt hai koi? Okay, perfect. Great. Good. Okay. So the next one is dictionary and set. Now understand it. The representation of dictionary is this one. The representation of set is this one. Okay. When I write this. When I write this empty, okay, because I didn't assign any kind of data between these two, so my Python will consider, important one, repeating once again, my Python will consider this both are dictionary objects. Sir I don't believe it, but you said that this is the set, you said that this is dictionary. Okay, now I am defining the difference between these two. Now first point, keep into the mind. In dictionary and in set, slicing and indexing, okay, slicing and indexing is not applicable. First point, sir, why so? Okay, when I talk about this list, now what exactly happened? This is the consecutive memory. Okay, for consecutive memory mean this is the zeroth memory, this is the one memory, and this is the two memory. Just take a simple scenario. I am talking about a street. This is just like a street. Okay. On the first place, there is house number one. On the second, the house number two. On the third, the house number three. Then easily I can proceed it. I can proceed this. Okay. Why so? Because this is the consecutive memory. And you can do over here slicing and indexing perfectly. In the case of tuple, okay, in the case of tuple, in the case of list, and in the case of string, in all these objects, whether it is string, whether it is tuple, whether it's a list, you can do slicing and indexing. Why so? Because these are the ordered, technically these are the ordered pair in the consecutive memory. It's take the consecutive memory, okay? But same thing inside dictionary and inside this set, slicing and indexing not applicable. Keep this point into the mind. Slicing and indexing not applicable. Yes, you are not supposed to perform the slicing, you are not supposed to perform the indexing in the case of dictionary. Sir, then how we can proceed the data? Now let's understand. Okay, so this is the basic funda. And why so? Because these are the unordered pair. Mean one house is here and the second house is somewhere else and the third house is somewhere else. Okay, this is the way. Okay, now if I talk about this dictionary, if I talk about this set, now understand the base is, the foundation is clear. The first concept, you are not supposed to perform slicing and indexing with the set and the dictionary, and you know the answer. Why so? Because these are the unordered pair. Okay, now I'm rubbing it. Okay, I'm completing the rubbing it. Now the dictionary, the dict object, dict basically, okay, for the convenience we pronounce it as a dictionary, but basically this is the dict, okay, and this is the set, but basically for our convenience we pronounce it as a dictionary. Now understand it. Dictionary is collection of key value pair. Okay, key value pair. Now sir, what is key, what is value? Okay, now understand it. D is equal to, let's suppose this is name of dictionary, you can take any name, curly brace, okay, 1:: let's suppose John, okay, comma. Now second:: Ravi, okay, perfect, comma. Now the next, keep understand carefully. Raj:: let's suppose Verma, okay. Now understand it. The next key value pair, let's suppose 108:220, okay. Now why I writing the, you know, the different keys and different values. Now this would be considered as a key, this would be considered as a value, this would consider as a key, this would consider as a value, this would consider as a key, this would consider as a value. Key value. Now listen my words carefully. Key can be anything, okay. Value can be anything. It is not hard and fast rule that key should be in the form of the integers. No, it is not like that. That's why I used over here key one, the mathematical one. Here I use the key, that is the Raj. Prior to these colon, it would be considered as a key. After that, it would be considered as a value. Okay, after that, it would be considered as a value. So here, if I talk about it, this Raj is a key, okay, and colon, and this is the associated value to this key. This is Verma is the value for this key. Okay, now this comma separate this key value pair. Okay, this is for the separation of these key value. This is the one key value pair, this is the one key value pair, this is the another key value pair, and this is the another key value pair. Okay, and keep this point into the mind. Here the key is into the integer format, here the key is into the string format. So what we clear from this point, key can be integer, value can be string. Sorry, key can be integer, value can be string, key can be string, and value can be string, और वैल्यू कैन बी इंटीजर, नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल. लेट सपोज की नंबर टू एक्स वाई जेड, ओके, एंड कॉलन कॉलन 506, नो प्रॉब्लम. यस, एक्सेप्टेबल एक्सेप्टेबल. ओनली वन थिंग दैट यू हैव टू कीप इन टू द माइंड, की शुड बी यूनिक, की शुड बी यूनिक. ओके, वाई सो इन क्लास, इन क्लास, इन ए क्लास, इन ए क्लास. जस्ट टेक ए सिंपल एग्जाम्पल. लेट सपोज दिस इज द कलेक्शन ऑफ द की वैल्यू पेयर. ओके, रोल नंबर वन, ओके, राम. ना रोल नंबर टू, रोल नंबर टू, लेट सपोज रवि. ओके, रोल नंबर थ्री, लेट सपोज एक्स वाई जेड. ओके, एंड सो ऑन, एंड सो ऑन. नाउ दिस रोल नंबर शुड बी यूनिक. द सेम कंसेप्ट हेयर, दिस की शुड बी यूनिक, की शुड बी यूनिक. देयर इज राम इज नथिंग इन साइड कॉलेज. राम इज नॉट ए आइडेंटिटी बिकॉज देर आर एन नंबर ऑफ पीपल डेट हैव सेम नेम, डेट इज द राम. बट रोल नंबर इज मेन आइडेंटिटी. वाई सो? बिकॉज इन साइड यूनिवर्सिटी, इन साइड कॉलेज, द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ दिस राम इज नॉट राम, दिस रोल नंबर, दिस रोल नंबर. ओके, नाउ आई थिंक यू क्लियर द कॉन्सेप्ट वाई की शुड बी यूनिक. एंड सेकेंड पॉइंट, इट इज अनऑर्डर्ड पेयर, सो स्लाइसिंग इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल. यू कान डू इट इफ यू समथिंग लाइक दिस डी ऑफ जीरो. नाउ वाट एग्जैक्टली मीनिंग? इट विल कंसिडरिंग, इट विल कंसिडरिंग दिस इज की. ओके, इफ द जीरो की इज नॉट अवेलेबल इन साइड दिस पर्टिकुलर डिक्शनरी, देन इट विल गिव यू द एरर मैसेज, की एरर, की एरर. ओके, बिकॉज इट्स इज नॉट ए इंडेक्स, इट विल कंसिडर एज ए की. फॉर स्लाइसिंग दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, फॉर स्लाइसिंग आई वॉन्ट टू प्रोसेस दिस रवि. फॉर रवि वॉट आई हैव टू डू? प्रिंट ऑफ, प्रिंट ऑफ डी ऑफ टू. ओके, प्रिंट ऑफ डी ऑफ टू. नाउ वॉट आउटपुट आई विल गेट? आई विल गेट दी एसोसिएटेड वैल्यू विद दिस की. एंड रवि इज एसोसिएटेड विद दिस की. वॉट आउटपुट आई विल गेट? आई विल गेट रवि. सो हेयर सेम थिंग. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू प्रोसेस दिस राज, ओके, इफ आई राइट दिस, इफ आई राइट दिस, प्रिंट डी ऑफ राज. ओके, आई एम पासिंग दिस की, आई एम पासिंग दिस की, एंड आई एम गेटिंग द एसोसिएटेड वैल्यू टू दिस. सो आउटपुट वुड बी वर्मा. ओके, सो आउटपुट वुड बी वर्मा. नाउ अंडरस्टैंड इट वन मोर टाइम. आई एम एलैबोरेटिंग इट बिकॉज दिस इज द न्यू वन फॉर यू गाइज. ओके, सो दिस इज द डिक्शनरी. आई वट आई एम डू? डी इज इक्वल टू, ओके, वन कॉलन, लेट सपोज आर, ओके, कॉमा, टू कॉलन, लेट सपोज द नेम इज सेम आर, बोथ ऑफ द केस इज राम, राम. ओके, बट द रोल नंबर इज यूनिक. दिस राम इज डिफरेंट, दिस राम इज डिफरेंट. वाई सो? बिकॉज द रोल नंबर इज डिफरेंस, द रोल नंबर इज डिफरेंट. ओके, नाउ द थर्ड इज, लेट सपोज द पर्सन राम कुमार. ओके, नाउ दिस टाइम लेट मी चेंज द नेम. सो ओके, सो अंडरस्टैंड इट, राहुल, ओके, कोमा चंडीगढ़, ओके, कोमा, लेट सपोज सीएससी ब्रांच. ओके, नाउ अंडरस्टैंड इट. सो दिस इज की, दिस इज की, दिस इज वैल्यू, दिस वैल्यू एसोसिएटेड विद दिस की, दिस इज की, एंड दिस इज द वैल्यू. दिस वैल्यू डजंट हैव एनी आइडेंटिटी. द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ दिस वैल्यू इज दिस टू. ओके, दिस इज की एंड दिस इज द वैल्यू. यस, वैल्यू कैन बी लिस्ट, वैल्यू कैन बी लिस्ट, नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल. वैल्यू कैन बी लिस्ट, वैल्यू कैन बी टपल, नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल. वैल्यू कैन बी डिक्शनरी ऑफ डिक्शनरी, दैट्स नॉट ए प्रॉब्लम. ओके, सो अंडरस्टैंड इट. नाउ आई वॉन्ट टू प्रोसेस दिस थर्ड, आई वॉन्ट टू प्रोसेस दिस थर्ड. फॉर द सेम वट आई हैव टू डू? प्रिंट ऑफ डी ऑफ थ्री. ओके, डी ऑफ थ्री, देन वट आउटपुट आई विल गेट? आई विल गेट राहुल, राहुल, ओके, सी एच डी, सी एच डी, एंड सी एस सी. दिस आउटपुट यू विल गेट बिकॉज दिस थर्ड की, थर्ड की कंटेन्स दिस वैल्यू, एंड दिस वैल्यू इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द लिस्ट. ओके, बाय डिफॉल्ट लिस्ट इंडेक्स यू गाइज नो, 0, 1, 2, बट आई वॉन्ट टू ओनली प्रोसेस द इंडेक्स ऑफ वन. ओके, इंडेक्स ऑफ वन फॉर दिस लिस्ट. फॉर द सेम वट आई हैव टू डू? प्रिंट, प्रिंट डी ऑफ थ्री. नाउ दिस इज, दिस इज की, की आई एम पासिंग. नाउ विच इंडेक्स आई वॉन्ट? आई वॉन्ट द इंडेक्स ऑफ, लेट सपोज वन. सो आई हैव टू पास ओवर हेयर वन. ओके दिस इज लिटल एडवांस कॉन्सेप्ट दैट आई एम टीचिंग यू. ठीक है ओके सो दिस इज वन. नाउ इन दिस केस इट विल हिट ओवर हेयर. इट विल ट्रीट द फर्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट एज ए की. ओके एंड द नेक्स्ट वन वुड बी कंसिडर एज ए दिस वन दैट इज द चंडीगढ़. वट आउटपुट यू विल गेट ओनली सी एच डी. नाउ आई थिंक दिस कंसेप्ट इज क्लियर. एंड दिस इज द म्यूटेबल. This is the mutable. Okay, mutable mean you can change the content by mistake. If you do the assignment mean you are assigning new value. Now d of 1, I am assigning this time John. Okay, John. Now this value has been updated over here. Now here is John. Why so? Because this is the mutable and this is the assignment operator. That what I am doing, I am changing the value of key 1, the old value is Ram, I am assigning the new value, that is the John. Now this has been updated. Why so? Because the concept of the mutable. Now I think it's clear. If you have any doubt, please do let me know. And does anyone having any doubt? Very good. Ajay sir. And what about Mohammed sir? Okay, perfect. Sanveer. I think Sanveer is not there. Okay, now understand the next one. Now the next is set. Later on, we will do in great detail this dictionary. There are various methods who are associated with this dictionary. I will show you and we will implement that method step by step. So at that time, please don't ask me questions, sir, what is dictionary? That's why I elaborated in great detail. Okay, keep this point into mind. Okay, now. Yeah, sure. For this line, yes. But we can do the indexing with this because this is the consecutive pair. This is the inside list. Okay. Yeah, no problem, you can define, but these are the little advanced concept. I just elaborated so that you guys will familiar to you guys won't surprise when you see something like this. So you can use over here the tuple, you can use over here the dictionary. Okay, so you can take anything. Okay, now perfect, good. Okay, the next one is, what about Mohammed sir? Everything is clearing? Are you getting? Okay, perfect. Now, the next one is set. Perfectly, very simple. Now, what is the difference between set and dictionary? The representation of both are same. Okay, now how I can define set? Set is collection of heterogeneous objects. Now, what is the meaning of the heterogeneous? You guys familiar with heterogeneous? Perfectly, the different data types. Okay, for example, 1, 2, okay, Ram, okay, you can take 80.5, perfectly, okay, you can take, let's suppose, again 1, again 2, okay, again Ram, okay, now, this would be considered as a set. Now, this time, this is the set. Why so? Because here is no key value pair, here is the collection of the heterogeneous object, and starting braces are these one, and ending braces are these one. So, it would be considered as a set for this time. It would be considered as a set. Okay. Now, what is the main property of set? When I print S, now what will happen? I will get output only unique objects. Okay. So, in this case, the output would be 1, 2, Ram, 80.5. Why so? Because it is the property of a set, the duplicates automatically removed. automatically removed. Inside set, the duplicates automatically removed. You will get only unique items. You will get only unique item. Why so? Because this is the property of the set, and set is collection of heterogeneous objects. Here there is no key, no value. Okay, now if you print type of s, you will get the output that is the class of set. Okay, class of set, and it is unordered pair. Slicing and indexing is not applicable. Keep this point into mind. Slicing and indexing is not applicable. You are not supposed to perform this operation. You will get the error message. Keep this point into the mind. While handling with set, this is the basic funda of set. It is the collection of the heterogeneous objects, and duplicates automatically removed. You will get only unique value. Now understand where the usage of this. Let's suppose you are getting a list. You are getting a list with similar mobile numbers. Okay, similar mobile numbers. Let's suppose this first mobile number. Okay, this is again second mobile number. This is again third. Then you are getting different. Then again you are getting same. Okay, you are getting different. Again same. Again different. And something like this. Okay, let's suppose you are getting the 100 different objects, and inside 100 there are only 35 or there are only 50 unique values. Okay, now you want to send the SMS to all these numbers. Okay, all these numbers. If you give this raw data, what will happen? Okay, it will send the message to this number 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time. Okay, you will send the message, the same message to this person for 4 time. Why so? Because you are implementing with this raw data. Now what you can do, the way number one, you have to remove these duplicates. Definitely you have to remove this duplicate. For that you have to write your own logic. And logic might be, it can take 2 lines of logic, or it can take 5 lines, or it can take 10 lines. This is the concept number one that you can do with this type of data. Okay, but what is their alternate way? I know the concept of the typecasting. The meaning of typecasting, you can convert one data type to another data type for the same. What you can do now, you can convert this list into set. So how? Print of set of this L. Perfect. Now this list is automatically converted into the set, and the property of a set, you know very well, remove the duplicate items. Now you will get only unique items, only 3 unique items, that is 98, 99 and 97. Now you can understand better why this set is used into the industry. This is the reason. One way, you are supposed to write your own logic. Okay, the logic can be take 10 lines, logic can be take 5 lines to remove the duplicates. Okay, the second way, simple one line of code. That's why the set is useful into this scenario. Okay, so if you have any doubt, please do let me know before proceed further. I will show you the practical for the same. Sorry, I didn't get. This list can be converted into the set. Okay, let me show you practical, then I think that there would be the more clarity. Just wait for a second. I'm showing you the practical. Okay, so after that I will take your question if you have any doubt. So let me show you practical. I am opening this shell. I am writing over here this one. Okay, first I am writing this. S is equal to this one. Okay, now D is equal to this one. If I print type of S, what output I will get? I will class output that is dictionary. Why so? As I know, the priority of the dictionary is higher than the set. Okay, if I print type of D, again I am getting this particular, that is the dictionary object. Okay, now I am differentiating both of these. Now this time what I am doing, now one colon, let's suppose R. Okay, two colon, let's suppose M. Okay, now set, in the case of set, I am doing 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 Okay, again I am writing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I am repeating this number 2 times and I am writing over here, let's suppose Ram. Okay, and again I am writing Ram. Okay, now this is set. The first is dictionary and the second one is set. Type of D. If I press type of D, what output I will get? I will get class of dictionary. If I press type of S, I will get in this case the class of set. Now you guys clear what is the difference between dictionary and set? Dictionary is collection of the key value pair. The set is the collection of the heterogeneous objects. Now if I print S, what output I will get? I will get automatically these unique items. The duplicates automatically removed. As you can see over here, the duplicates automatically removed. I didn't write a single line of code for the same. It automatically converted because this is the property of the set. The same thing. Okay, the same thing. Let's suppose now this is my list which contain the duplicate items. Okay, which contains the duplicate item. The way number one, I want to remove the duplicates from this particular list. The way number one, that what you have to do, you have to write your own logic which will automatically remove these which will manually remove these particular duplicate of items. So for the same, it can be 2 lines, it can be 4 line, or it can be 10 line of code. Okay, but alternate way, what I can do typecasting. As I know the concept of the typecasting, what I did, I simply convert this L into the set. Now if I print XX, now you can check it out, automatically remove the items that are duplicate. Okay, the same thing, but my requirement is, after converting the set, my operation is done, but I need again it into the list. For the same, what I can do, L is equal to list of XX. Now again this L has been converted into the list. Why so? Because first I did this operation, I convert it into the set. Okay, now I convert this output, the output given by this method, this set function, then I convert this value again into the list. This is the concept of the typecasting. Okay, now I think clear, Mohammed? Okay, perfect. So anyone having any doubt, please do let me know. हाँ जी सर, आपको विकास सर? ओके, परफेक्ट. सो प्रोसीड फर्दर. सो बेसिक्स हैज बीन डन, वेरी बेसिक्स. नाउ यू गाइज आर क्लियर विद इंट, स्ट्रिंग, लिस्ट, you know, the tuple, dictionary and set. My basic task has been done. So you guys can easily, you know, write simple codes. So we are proceeding further. Okay, so we are proceeding further. Now understand my next concept. Okay, I am writing once again. Understand my next concept. Okay, just take a simple example of calculator. What exactly calculator do? It performs the mathematical operation. The value given by user. Okay, let's suppose user give this 10 plus 20. Okay, 10 plus 20, you are getting 30. Now, perfect. Okay, so let's suppose you are using a calculator which gives you always 30. It will never ask the value from you. When you click on equals to sign, okay, it's automatically give you 30. Is that calculator is valid? Will you use that calculator? No, you will never use. Why so? Because every time when you press this equal to sign, it's always give you 30, and this is not a valid calculator. What is the definition of valid calculator? It asks the values from user. Let's suppose you first time you enter this 10, and the next time you enter this 50 and you press this plus operation, you are getting the output that is the 60. Okay, second time you give 100 plus 50, you are getting the output 150. Because why so? Because this is the dynamic concept. This concept is called dynamic concept. Here the concept of the static concept. Okay, every time you are getting the 30 output, that is not a valid calculator. So for same type of activity, I want to get the values from user means get the value from user means user enter any value. Let's suppose you enter 5000, okay, or 500 or 50,000. It perform the operation according to requirement. Whatever operation that you want to perform, let's suppose you want to perform plus, it perform the plus. If you want to perform minus, it perform the minus. But these values should be supplied by the user. That is the valid calculator. For same thing. Okay, I want to achieve inside the Python. What my main concept, that I want to ask the value from user. That is my requirement. Okay, for the same. How I can ask the value from the user? There is a method. Not method, there is function basically. There is a function, and that function name is called input. Okay, that function name is called input. Now we will use this input function to ask the value from user. Now we are entering into the coding world. Now we are supposed to write the small logics, small problems, okay, with the help of this input. Now understand carefully how we can proceed with this, because this time we are not using this shell. Okay, now we will write a code into notepad. Okay, for this time we'll write a code into notepad. Now understand it. So go into any drive. Let's suppose I am going into my F drive. Let's suppose I am going into you guys use any of your drive. Okay, I am going to my this drive, Python for basics. Okay, my work. Okay, I am using, let's suppose this folder. Okay, do one thing. I am making a new folder. The name of the folder is, let's suppose UK and Ireland batch. Okay, so UK and Ireland batch. I am making this folder. Okay, now here I am opening it. Okay, first concept, you have to print over here cmd. okay, now you will get this command prompt. Here inside command prompt, first you have to print this py. If you guys get this, it's mean your Python path has been settled down. You don't need to do anything extra. Okay, some people's PC, what will happen in some machines, what will happen if py is not recognized, then you have to write this Python. Okay, you have to write this Python. In some of the PCs, the Python shell is open with the complete name Python. In some PCs, the Python shell open with the help of this py. Okay, so this is your first task to get clarity, get confirmation your Python path is settled down. If you have done this, then everything is fine. Now you are supposed to write the code. Okay, in some systems, if you get the error message from here, if you get the error message from there, what you can do simply Python 3. Okay, Python 3, because my system take py or my system take this Python. So now you can observe it, Python 3 is not recognized. If you get this error message over here, then try for this one. try for this one. If you again get the error message over here, something like this, Python is not recognized, then you are supposed to try for this. If you get the error message in both of the cases, then what you have to do? Follow my video. Okay, follow my video which I already shared with you guys. Here, there, I explain each and everything, why this error is coming and how you can resolve this error message. Okay, so there, the option I am just giving you the hint for the same. The option is pip. Okay, you have to confirmation it, pip is working or not. For the same, you get the clarity about the same. Just watch that video in depth. Okay, so my first task is done. My system that recognizes Python, perfectly working, no problem at all. Okay, now what I have to do in this case? Now observe carefully. Here I have to click new text document, okay, and open it. What I have to do over here? Now I will write the complete Python code into these notepads. Okay, so my editor is this notepad where I will write the code. I will write each and every code into the notepad. Why I am using this notepad? Some of instructors, some of trainer use Jupyter notebook. Okay, some of trainer use Spyder, some of trainer use IntelliJ. Okay, some of trainer use some another IDEs, but I will never suggest you, as at beginning age, at fresher age, never goes with these kind of IDEs. Why so? I'm giving you the valid reason. Why so? Okay, let's suppose I'm using this IDLE. Okay, I'm using this IDLE. When I use this list. Okay, so let's suppose I want to check it out the method for same. I will press l.tab. It will automatically give me the hint that these are the method associated with this list. Very easy. Now what will happen in this case? When you use such kind of helps at starting age, I'm repeating once again, at starting age, if you're trying to take some kind of helps, you will become the dependent. Okay, you will become the dependent. You always looking from this dot, and you are waiting, okay, please help me. I don't know how many methods are there, how many functions are there. Okay, so that's why I never recommend you go with these kind of IDEs, because it make you dependent on them, on basically IDEs. So inside notepad, let's suppose if I do this and I press l.tab, you will get nothing. And this practice make you a perfect programmer. Okay, this practice make you perfect programmer. It will help you to clear your Microsoft examination, because inside your Microsoft examination, no one goes to help you. Okay, so there your practice and your mind will help a lot. So this type of, that's why in the fresher and at the starting age, I always recommend write a program into the notepad. Starting days, you will feel little, you know, the difficulty with this. But as the day by day you grown up with this Python, it become very easy for you to keep remember each and everything. Automatically your finger will work on getting the instruction from your mind. So I will use throughout this course this notepad, and I always suggest you, please work on this notepad kind of things. Okay, max to max what you can do, you can install this Notepad++. Okay, let me show you like this. It's also good for working. Notepad++, simply you have to write a Google write inside the Google Notepad++, something like this. Okay, I am writing it Notepad++. Okay, it will automatically give you the link for the download it. It's also very good. It's also doesn't give you any kind of reference, but it's simply give you this kind of colors, and it makes the more clarity. Okay, so you can go with this Notepad++, or you can go with this Notepad. I will suggest both of these to you for at the starting age, but later on when you will become expert, then I will automatically say you, okay, go with the Jupyter notebook or go with some another notebook. But from the starting days, please work. It is my recommendation, okay, to everyone start work on the notepad only for starting this at least, so that you guys can get the best hold into the programming language. Okay, so that's it. Now back to this point. Okay, you can guys see I did today a simple task, and I use the notepad. I write this code into the Python for fetching the data from the websites. Okay, and I use again the notepad. It's my general practice that I always use the notepad to writing the code for Python. So anyways, now inside this folder, new text notepad. Okay, now observe carefully, very simple. How I can do, let's suppose x is equal to 30, okay, y is equal to 20, okay, and then c is equal to, or z is equal to x plus y. Okay, now print this z. Perfect, this is very very simple code. Add two number inside the Python. How it will execute? Now observe carefully. File, save as. Okay, save as. Write name of the program. Let's suppose I am writing test.py. okay, and this py.py is the extension for same. Okay, now my system will understand this test file belong to the Python file. Okay, for here, but I have to do just simply save. Now you can see here is a file with the name test. Now you can see it with the extension of py. Py mean the Python extension. By default I installed notepad++, that's why it's coming into this format. Otherwise it's come into this format. Okay, when I double click it, now you can see your code. Okay, x is equal to 30, y is equal to 20, z is equal to x plus y, print z. Now the question is, how I can run this code for the same. Okay, now I am closing this for you guys make more clarity. For closing this, I am opening it with notepad. Okay, I am opening with notepad only. Okay, so now you guys will check how I can run this Python file for the same. You have to click over here and write cmd. okay, now write cmd. Now you can observe this, the same path. You are into this PC, big data, Python for basics, my work, UK and Ireland batch, and you can see out over here Python for basics, my work, UK and Ireland. What meaning of this? I am inside this folder. I am supposed to process the data from this folder. Okay, so how I can run this Python file for the same py space test.py. Now I am giving this file to Python for processing. Okay, now when I press enter, you can see the output is 50. Okay, you can see the output is 50. Why so? Because I use x is equal to 30, y is equal to 20, z is equal to x plus y, and printing the value of z. When I performing this plus operation on x and y, what exactly happening? It is adding these two numbers, and I am printing that result which I stored into z. Okay, now output I am getting 50. And if I run it 50 times, okay, if I run it 1000 times, if I run this 10,000 times, always I will get the output that is 50. Okay, always I will get output that is 50. Is this calculator valid which always give you the 50? No, it is not useful. For making it useful, what I can do, a program which asks the value from user, and perform the operation on that given values for the same. What you have to do now observe carefully. I open this file, and I already discussed, we have one beautiful function. That function is called input. Okay, I am using this inside this braces into double quotes. What I write that would appear on the screen. Let's suppose I am writing enter value for, okay, enter value or enter first number, simply enter first number. Okay, okay, this will appear on the screen, this will appear on the screen as it is. Whatever you write over here, whatever you write over here, it as it is appeared on the screen. Okay, so normally this is for the information, nothing else. Normally this is for the information, whatever I write. Okay, I write this colon. Okay, as it is, it will come on the screen. So what is the what exactly the role of this? Okay, when you go into the, you know, into the Gmail account, okay, into the Gmail account or into any website, there they will ask your username and password. Okay, they will ask your username and password. There is something like this. Okay, let me draw over here. There is something like this, one box, okay, and second box. In the front of one box they said and username, and the second box they said password. Okay, if I remove this, what makes sense? You will never understand what this box is asking, what this box is asking. But when I write over here username, you automatically understand that your supply over you have to enter your username over here, and for this colon they mention this password. Okay, now you will get the information. Okay, this column is used for entering the password. If I remove this, you guys may confuse. Okay, so these are called labels. Okay, the same task over here, whatever you write into the double quote inside this input function, okay, inside this input function, it will as it is appear on the screen. It will ask enter first number. Now you guys will clear, you guys give, okay, it is asking first number. Okay, same thing after second time, again enter second number. So let me show you how we can do it. Okay, let me show you. So in the second case, let's suppose I press over here y is equal to input of, sorry, caps lock should not be there, it will give you the error message, input of enter second number. Okay, now same thing. Now what number you will give, that would be assigned to x. What second number you will give, that would be assigned to y. Now I want to perform the operation on this. Okay, the operation is same, x plus y. Okay, now I am printing this get. Now how I can run this? Prior to run this, you have to do save. Okay, whatever changes you made into this test file, it is mandatory to save it, then it will reflect with same, otherwise it will take the previous code. Okay, so keep this point into the mind. While if you did any change inside your code, it is mandatory to save it. Okay, otherwise you will get the previous code. So keep this point into the mind, or you can use control plus s. Okay, control s, that is alternate way to save it. Now how, if I run this, I know how to run this, py space test dot py. Now you can see it is asking enter first number. You enter first number, let's suppose 31. Okay, now you enter second number, let's suppose 45. Now operation you satisfied on these two, that is the plus operator. Okay, now understand it. What output you are getting? 3 1 4 5. Why so? I already discussed today into this session. Okay, when I perform this, okay, this operator on strings, what output I will get? I will get 3145. So what I have to do over here? Now what observation? By default, this input, keep this point into the mind, important one, this input is a function which take data in form of string. Okay, in form of string, by default this input is a function which take the data in the form of the string. So we know we are required output, we have to perform the add operation. So when I add it, what output I will get? I will get 76. For getting the 76, I know what I have to perform. We have to perform the concept of the typecasting, that we have to convert data from this string to integer for the same what you have to do. Now observe carefully. Okay, for the same what I have to do, I have to do the type casting. Okay, now this x is string, you have to convert it into the integer. This y is string, that you have to convert it into the integer for the same. Okay, I did type casting int x plus int y, and for the same I am saving it, control s. Okay, or you can use this save, choice is again your, okay, the shortcut is control s. Okay, but you can use control s or you can this option. Now this code has been saved. Okay, now what I am doing, cls for clearing the screen. If you want to remove the previous work, just simply write cls. okay, now again run this py space test.py. when you press enter, now it will asking enter first number, you enter first number 66. okay, you enter second number 45. now it, what will happen when execute this first line, it gets the value that you assign 66 into the x, after that 45, you assign 45 into the y, after that you did the type casting. What you did, you convert this data into the integer, and perform the plus operator. After performing the plus operator, that you are displaying the data on the screen. For print function, is used to display the data on the screen. And when I press enter, you will get the output, that is 111. Now it's perform the mathematically plus operation. Okay, one more. This time I am writing 10 space. Okay, this time I am writing this space. Now you are getting this output. Okay, perfect. Now this time I am writing 1 2 3 4 5 at the rate. Okay, 4 5 6 7 8 5. Again I am writing question mark. Now you can understand what error out I will get invalid literals. Okay, so why? So because these are the special characters, they cannot be converted into the integer. For the same, it is mandatory. Okay, for the same, what you can do for the user, enter first number should be in integer. Okay, integer. Okay, again should be in integer, so it will give you the error message to the user. Okay, this should be into the integer. Now understand it. Okay, perfect. Now enter first number should be in integer. Okay, 10. Enter second number, that should be into the integer. Okay, 20. Now you will get the, that is 30. Okay, so I think the picture is clear. Okay, if anyone having doubt, please do let me know. Haan ji, bilkul sir, poochiye. No sir, it doesn't relevant with your code. This is for the error message. I already told you. If you want to something like this. Okay, the same message would be appear on the screen. Let me show you. Okay, the same message will appear on the screen. It doesn't have any concern. Okay, it doesn't have any. No, input that you have to take into the small letters. No, chota, everything is into the small letter. Python mein sab kuch chote letters mein hi likha jata hai sir. 90% chote mein hi likha jata hai. There are some things that should be take the capital letter. For example, true or false. Okay. Anyone having any doubt? I think I explain in much detail. Definitely, sir. Definitely. उसमें बेसिकली सर इंटीग्रेट होता है सर, इंटीग्रेशन करनी पड़ती है अपने को. जैसे आर्डिनो आपने सुना होगा, है ना? आर्डिनो सुना आपने? एक्चुअली क्या होता है, जैसे आपका मान के चलो कोई भी डिवाइस है, उसके अंदर बफर सिस्टम होता है, उसके अंदर मेमोरी होती है, उस मेमोरी के अंदर हम कोड कर देते हैं। वो बैकएंड पे कोड ही होता है सर, कैलकुलेटर इज इटसेल्फ ए कोड, इट द सेम कोड, एग्जैक्टली दिस कोड इज देयर, समथिंग लाइक दिस। लेकिन वो कोई और लैंग्वेज में हो सकता है, वो सी में हो सकता है, सी प्लस प्लस में हो सकता है। ओके, वैसे बेसिकली वो आर्डिनो में है, आई सपोज द कोड इज इन टू द आर्डिनो, क्योंकि इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स चिप्स में जब हम कोडिंग करते हैं ना, सी लैंग्वेज ज़्यादा यूज़ होती है। और अगर लेकिन अगर मैं आईओटी के साथ डील करना है तो पाइथन काफ़ी यूज़ हो रही है। तो उसमें भी हम क्या करते हैं, रसबेरी पाई आपने शायद सुना होगा, रसबेरी पाई होता है जस्ट लाइक ए स्मॉल कंप्यूटर, बिल्कुल इतनी सी चिप होती है, इतनी सी, उसको रसबेरी पाई बोलते हैं। और उसको आप सिस्टम के साथ लगाओ, किसी भी टीवी के साथ लगाओ, वो टीवी आपका जस्ट लाइक ऑपरेट एज ए कंप्यूटर। तो यहाँ पे आप पोर्ट्स होते हैं, यू कैन ऐड यू नो कीबोर्ड, यू कैन ऐड माउस, वो छोटी सी चिप रहती है, उसकी जो चार्जिंग कॉस्टिंग है आई सपोज 5,000 रुपीज़ है अकॉर्डिंग टू इंडियन रुपीज़। ओके, एनी वन एल्स हैविंग एनी डाउट, बिकॉज दिस इज द इम्पोर्टेंट वन, ये हम वी विल डू दिस प्रैक्टिस थ्रू आउट आवर सेशन, वी विल वर्क ऑन दिस नोट पैड, तो कीप ऑन प्रैक्टिस। एंड इफ एनी वन हैविंग एनी डाउट बिफोर एंडिंग दिस सेशन, अजय सर डू यू हैव एनी डाउट? यस डेफिनेटली सर, ये ऑन दिस एरिया एक्चुअली एक्चुअली आप, यस यस यू आर यूजिंग द मैक, तो मैक में ऊपर देखो कुछ ऐसे करके ब्लैक सा बना होगा, समथिंग लाइक दिस टर्मिनल, बेसिकली जो मैक में इसको टर्मिनल बोलते हैं सर, टर्मिनल ऐसे ब्लैक सा होगा, ऐसे करके ना, ऐसे करके ब्लैक सा आप सर्च मारना, यस टर्मिनल बोलते हैं, यू 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 सर्च फॉर द टर्मिनल। ओके, एंड व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू रीच ऑन दिस डेस्टिनेशन। ओके, फॉर एग्जांपल अगर आप ये यूज़ कर रहे हो, मैक यूज़ कर रहे हो, तो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, वहाँ पे आपको उस डेस्टिनेशन में जाना पड़ेगा, यू हैव टू रीच ऑन दिस फोल्डर मैनुअली। ओके, सो फॉर एंटर दी मैनुअली इन टू दी फोल्डर, व्हाट यू यू आर सपोज टू यूज, मैं आपको एक बार दिखा देता हूँ। फॉर एग्जाम्पल आपने टर्मिनल ओपन किया, तो आपका टर्मिनल समथिंग लाइक ऐसे ओपन होगा। ओके, इसको भी लेट मी क्लोज इट। ओके, इफ आई राइट दिस टर्मिनल, आपका टर्मिनल है, यहाँ पे कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट है, समथिंग लाइक दिस, माई होम इज दिस वन, आपका समथिंग लाइक ऐसे होगा, स्लैश जो भी आपका यूजर होगा ना, आपका जो होगा वो ऐसे होगा स्लैश, ठीक है जी, उसके बाद आपका यूजर स्लैश समथिंग लाइक दिस। ओके, सो मैन्युअली हाउ यू कैन रीच ओवर देयर, फॉर एग्जाम्पल अब इनसाइड दिस मशीन व्हाट आई हैव टू डू, लेट्स सपोज आई एम मूविंग इन टू दी एफ ड्राइव। ओके, सो दिस इज द वे टू मूव टू दी एफ ड्राइव। ओके, आई नाउ यू कैन चेक इट आउट, आई एम एंटरिंग इन टू दी एफ ड्राइव एंड आई वॉन्ट टू एंटर इन टू द स्पेसिफिक फोल्डर, फॉर द सेम डेट आई हैव टू राइट द नेम ऑफ द फोल्डर, सी डी स्पेस, लेट्स सपोज माई फोल्डर नेम वॉज बिग डेटा। ओके, सो लेट मी डी आई आर विच डिस्क्राइब यू ऑल दी कंटेंट, ऑल दी फोल्डर डेट इज अवेलेबल इन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्टरी, लेट सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू एंटर इन टू दिस। ओके, आई वॉन्ट टू एंटर इन टू दिस नितिन प्रोजेक्ट्स। ओके, फॉर द सेम वट आई हैव टू डू, सी डी स्पेस नितिन स्पेस, ओके, पी एल सी के पी आर ओ जे, वट इज, लेट सपोज दिस इज द डायरेक्टरी यूएस डेटा टेक्नोलॉजीज। ओके, दिस इज द डायरेक्टरी। ओके, नाउ यू कैन चेक इट आउट, आई एम इनसाइड दिस यूएस डेटा टेक्नोलॉजीज। ओके, लेट सपोज इसके अंदर आई वॉन्ट टू चेक इट आउट ऑल द फोल्डर इनसाइड दिस डायरेक्टरी, देन आई हैव टू यूज दिस डी आई आर। सो यू कैन चेक आउट देर इज वन फाइल डेट इज कॉल्ड डेटा, हाउ टू एंटर इट, डेटा। ओके, अगेन चेक डी आई आर, यू विल गेट, ओके देर आर दीज आर द फाइल, डेटा ड्राइवर डॉट जावा, डेटा मैपर डॉट जावा, देर वुड बी समथिंग फाइल समथिंग लाइक दिस टेस्ट डॉट पी वाई, इफ यू हैव क्रिएटेड इन साइड दिस डायरेक्टरी देन यू विल फाइंड इट आउट ओवर हेयर। ओके, सो दिस इज द वे, दिस इज द वे टू गो द मैनुअली, अदरवाइज यू हैव टू टेक द हेल्प ऑफ द यूट्यूब और गूगल, डू सम रिसर्च। सो ओके, दिस इज द बेसिक वे, बेसिक वे यू हैव टू यूज दिस सी डी, सी डी टू करंट डायरेक्टरी Okay, I have to current directory. I am moving to this directory. This is the data directory. Now you can check it out over here. I enter into this data. Firstly, I enter into the major main root directory, that is US Data Technology, and inside this US Data Technology there is one more directory that is called data. The way to enter into this directory, you can use the cd space data. And again, the dir is a command. I don't know the dir will be run over there or not, because inside Linux the command is ls. Okay, ls. So might be there would be the command, that command name is ls, which will list out all the content into this particular directory. So this is the way, the manual way. I give you the little hint and you have to do some practice. If you done good, otherwise I will help you into the next class. So keep on research, you have Sunday. Okay, what about Mohammed sir? Do you have any doubt? Okay, I will give you the assignment, just have patience. I am just taking out the doubts of everyone, then I will move for the assignment. Okay, so I think the picture is clear. I elaborated in great detail. I took a lot of time to, you know, elaborate this thing, because this is the foundation step and this is the important one. If you have, I will share the recording for the same. If you have any doubt, you can check it out, the recording for the same. So try by your own. Okay, and you have Sunday, and one assignment from my side for you all, for all of you. The first assignment, very simple assignment. The 90% this code is same. Okay, the assignment number one, what you have to do, you have to simply do operation plus, minus, multiplication, okay, divide and modulus, and one you have to use power, and you have to also check out the difference between these two. Dhani, what exactly you have to do, you are supposed to take the two values from the user. Okay, you just take the two values from the user, let's put 10 and second value is 5. Okay, now first operation, what first output I will get, I will get first output, that is 15. The second one is 10 minus 5, I will get 5. Okay, continues, complete outputs. Okay, the same thing, for same thing, if I use this terminal, okay, if I use this terminal, so I think I close that. So now you can understand it, what output I will get. Okay, here I am printing z. Okay, that's why I am getting only one thing, only one result, that is add of two numbers. But my requirement is I need plus result, same time, keep this point into the mind, same time it will ask only two numbers. Let's suppose enter first number, you enter first number, that is 10. Enter second number, let's suppose you enter 5. Okay, now when you press enter, what output you will get? You will get addition, that is 15. Okay, same, subtraction, that is 5, multiplication, that is 50. Okay, divide, that is 3.0. okay, divide with floor division, that is your for example 3. Okay, something like this. I will get this as output in one shot. Okay, in one shot I will enter only two numbers and I will get output, this combination set of output that I have to generate on the screen. I'm giving you the hint for the same, little hint for the same. Let's suppose I want to display the message prior to the output. So for the same, what I have to do, I have to write anything into the double quotes. Let's suppose addition is, and then you have to press this comma. Okay, now if I run this, now you can check it out the output. If I run this code, okay, if I run this code, let's suppose 10 and 20, now you are getting the message with that addition is 30. Okay, so I give you the hint for the same. So for this kind of task, what you can do, inside print, inside double quotes, the same, whatever you write, that doesn't concern with the code. This is only for the information message. Whatever into the double quote, that is concern only for the information method, that is nothing else, that doesn't belong to your logic and that doesn't belong to your code. Keep this point into the mind, the information is totally your English. Okay, it's just a information message to the user. After processing this, what output you are getting, addition is, and you are supposed to process the value of this operator, this variable, you have to take the help of this comma. Okay, for the help of this comma. So I think the picture is clear. Okay, assignment is clear, Mohammed sir, assignment is clear. Okay, Ajay sir and Vikas sir, clear, everyone clear? So whatever, अगर तो आपकी हो जाती है, दैट्स वेल एंड गुड. ओके, जस्ट जस्ट सेंड मी द स्क्रीन शॉट, इन शेयर द स्क्रीन शॉट इन टू द ग्रुप. कैन आई गिव वन मोर असाइनमेंट और सिंगल इज मोर देन सफिशियंट फॉर टूडे? ओके, सो टेक वन मोर असाइनमेंट, वेरी सिंपल असाइनमेंट दिस टाइम. ओके, नाउ असाइनमेंट नंबर वन इज क्लियर डेट यू हैव टू क्रिएट द कैलकुलेटर. असाइनमेंट नंबर टू, जस्ट कीप दिस पॉइंट इन टू द माइंड. हेयर द यू हैव टू यूज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द टाइप कास्टिंग. ओके, टाइप कास्टिंग. नाउ अंडरस्टैंड इट. द फर्स्ट डेट आस्क द नेम, नेम ऑफ एम्प्लॉय. ओके, लेट सपोज आई एंटर रवि. ओके, एंड एज, लेट सपोज आई एंटर 30 और 32, वट एवर. ओके, एंड सैलरी, लेट सपोज 25,000. ओके, एंड एज, एंड देन मैरिटल स्टेटस. मैरिटल स्टेटस, यू हैव टू प्रिंट दिस मैसेज ऑन द स्क्रीन. इफ पर्सन इज मैरिड देन यू हैव टू प्रेस 1, एल्स यू हैव टू प्रेस 0. दिस मैसेज शुड बी अपेयर ऑन द स्क्रीन प्रायर टू टेक द वैल्यू. यू नो हाउ यू कैन डिस्प्ले दिस मैसेज? वेरी सिंपल, एंटर मैरिटल स्टेटस. इफ मैरिड देन प्रेस एंटर, एल्स प्रेस 0. नाउ द पर्सन, लेट सपोज द रवि इज मैरिड, ही विल प्रेस 1, अदरवाइज ही विल प्रेस 0. ओके, सो टेक केयर दिस पॉइंट. यू आर टेकिंग डेटा ओवर हेयर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ 1 एंड 0. ओके, नाउ द आउटपुट शुड बी समथिंग लाइक दिस ऑन स्क्रीन. हेलो रवि. ओके, योर एज इज 25 एंड योर सैलरी. कीप दिस पॉइंट इन टू द माइंड. यू हैव एंटर सैलरी इन टू दिस एंड यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट इट इन टू द फ्लो. ओके, द सैलरी इज 25,000. इट ऑटोमेटिकली डन. यू नो द टाइप कास्टिंग कॉन्सेप्ट, वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस. ओके, एंड मैरिटल स्टेटस, लेट्स सपोज द पर्सन एंटर 1, दैट्स मीन मैरिटल स्टेटस इज ट्रू. ओके, आउटपुट वुड बी समथिंग लाइक दिस, ट्रू. एल्स लेट्स सपोज द पर्सन एंटर 0, देन द आउटपुट वुड बी फॉल्स. कीप दिस पॉइंट इन टू द माइंड. आई एम गिविंग यू द हिंट फॉर द सेम दैट टाइप कास्टिंग वी कैन यूज बूल. ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन टू टूडेज सेशन द बूल. ओके, द फ्लोट. ओके, एंड यू नो हाउ टू परफॉर्म द टाइप कास्टिंग. सो दिस इज सेकेंड असाइनमेंट फॉर यू गाइज. नाउ आई थिंक द पिक्चर इज क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट इन टू द सेकेंड असाइनमेंट, यू कैन लेट मी नो. आई थिंक क्लियर. ओके, सो दैट्स इट फॉर द डे. ओके सर. ओके, सो ओके सर. थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू.